questions from 10 to 1. How's that? So the question is, what's your message for the public, for Yana here? What, I know that you have repeatedly said many things, but because we are taking note and this is being reported, then we can then conclude and maybe hold you accountable for this. So the question is how this public would gather here to help with this case, and how can you personally help with that cause? We can start from you, Payam, because you were laughing at us.
Well, is Olivia Ward in the room? Where's Olivia?
She's out.
Oh, that's too bad. Okay, well, I want to... Okay, good, because I want to recognize Olivia Ward, who's an amazing, amazing woman. She, for years, has been writing about Hamid, about Saeed, about really, and you see, this is it. She doesn't have to do that. She doesn't have to do that. It's not necessarily in the interest of her career. She does it because of... Hi, Olivia.
Absolutely verify that that's essential to gaining freedom. And I think we can and must move out of this amazing gathering tonight with that sort of commitment taken right to our hearts. But let's make it concrete. So I'm going to give you all a challenge. It's Friday night, the weekend's ahead. And I want everyone in this room to make this a weekend where you're going to find 10 people who don't know about Saeed's case, who haven't thought about Saeed's case, who haven't taken action on Saeed's case. And by the end of the weekend, your responsibility and challenge is to have convinced those 10 people to have taken action. Just look at the numbers who are here tonight. Imagine if we accomplished that just in the next 48 hours. But then keep it going. Keep it going for the days and the weeks to come. I think that's absolutely what we have to come out of tonight.
Well, I guess I just want to repeat what Alex has said. It's very important that we keep talking about it, keep his name on the agenda. I know that in my case, I don't have a Facebook myself. I'm not so digitally advanced. But I realize so many people know, for instance, about my case through friends of friends and friends. And so the Facebook became one of the major means into people being informed about my case. And letter writing and talking to other people, I think it's very important again to keep this his name on the agenda, to talk about it, and also asking friends to write letters and doing whatever they can to write to the Canadian government, write to your MPs, write to the Iranians, and I think it's also that is very important for them to get the letter that there are people who demand his release. So I think solidarity work and campaigning is very important to all at this stage. And let's make the day Malakou's day and keep talking about him. That's the most important one. And those of you who are journalists and have access to media, please do use it. It does make a difference. Thank you.
I'd like to add my voice to the champions on this table, and I can't express how important it is indeed to keep, you know, using these hashtags and you know, advocating and speaking to the press and translating from English to Iranian for those who don't understand back in Iran how important the story is. And I just want to say, as a journalist, journalists get bored very easily, and you need to get their attention sometimes and give them a reason to revisit the story, a peg. A reason to keep going and reporting this story. And just by you being here, I'm sure there are journalists who are here today to cover this event, and their editors are now convinced of why they should write about the story. So it is very important to keep the journalists always engaged and keep the story in the press. And I'm traveling to Geneva end of the month, and Mr. Irwin is going to be there as well, and we will be speaking about Saeed's case there, among other cases, because it's and should be an international issue, not just a local Canadian issue. This is a man's life we're talking about here, and a man who's innocent, and we should capitalize on every single political event, human rights event, and any chance that we can get to help him. And I hope the Canadian government is listening, because they have intervened in the past for non-Canadians, and they should be doing this for Saeed. Thank you.
I think each one in this room should see himself and herself as being an advocate on behalf of Saeed, and thereby create a critical mass of advocacy, internationalize that advocacy, sustain it, and if we keep at it, we will see Saeed securing the freedom we all want for. Thank you.
Thank you so very much for these insightful comments, and really appreciate your coming to tonight, Friday night, some from long distances. Before you leave the stage, because we have a few more minutes, I just want to ask Mostafa to come to this stage one more time to say a few words about Saeed, to end the night with his comment, with your permission, and then we're going to have a, take a picture with that artwork with all of you here on the stage. Mostafa, please come.
Thank you.
giving me another chance to talk about Saeed.
من بیشتر میخوام راجع به این صحبت کنم که یک زندانی تنها امیدش به ماهایی که بیرون هستیم که چه کار میتونیم بکنیم برای اینکه آزادش کنیم.
I just want to focus on this issue that, you know, the prisoner's only hope is us, the people who are outside, and can help the prisoner to release the prisoner.
چون اگر که امید نباشه هیچ چیزی برای زندانی باقی نمیمونه. من برای اینکه روحیه سعید رو بگم یک خاطره دیگه برای تعریف میکنم. یک ماده قانونی هست به نام ماده 134 که از همون ماده قانونی استفاده شد من آزاد شدم.
Just to, if there's no hope for a prisoner, then basically nothing is left for the prisoner. So just to tell you a few more words about Saeed's personality, there's this law in Iran based on which one number 134 in the Iran judicial law, so which was used to free me from prison.
Saeed, وقتی که حکمش از اعدام حذف شد، تبدیل شد به حبس ابد به اضافه 8 سالی.
When his death sentence was reduced to life sentence, it was actually reduced to life sentence plus 8.5 years in prison.
بعد یک روز سعید با خوشحالی اومد گفتش که یه خبر خیلی خوب دارم. گفتم سعید چی شده خبر خوب؟ آزاد شد. گفت نه 8 سال و نیم حبس کردم.
One day we saw Saeed running to us joyfully, and we asked him, okay, what's going on, Saeed? Are you going to be free? He said, no, no, they got rid of me in 8.5 years.
But so what do I wish about Saeed? I mean, I go, man, all the time I'm going to have the hour, 120 years بعد از آزادی زندگی کنم تا به کسایی که می‌خواستم رو قابل به دخترم بگم من زندگی.
Show the people who wanted to, me to be in prison for life that I'm going to stay alive for that long.
من وقتی که اینجا در تورنتو از سعید دفاع میکردم جلوی سفارت اون موقع سفارت داشتم میشد از این کار کرد.
In front of the Iranian embassy in Canada, which doesn't exist anymore, he was saying it's too bad because we can't protest anymore from the embassy. I was only doing it for human rights purposes because I didn't even know Saeed, and to be honest, I even thought he's probably, you know, has done what they're claiming he's done.
ولی وقتی که این شانس میتونم بگم نصیبم شد که برم زندان ادیم و با سعید زندگی کنم و هشت داشته باشم، اون وقت دیدم که من از یک دوستی که انگار سالهاست میشناسمش دفاع کردم، از یک انسان فوق‌العاده، از یک انسان بسیار فهیم، انسانی که اونجا میگم نمونش تعریف کردم یاور آفریقایی تبارهایی بود که هیچ کس رو نداشته و سعید دارش رو کار میکرد، ذره نژادپرستی، ذره مسئله که اصلا فکر کردن راجعه اینه که جرم زندانی چیه، اینا تو سعید نبود. یک انسان خالصی است که به معنای واقعی برای حقوق بشر، حقوق بشر، نمیدونم چه چیزی میخوام ترجمه کنم، به ما حقوق بشر.
Okay, he's testing me now. So basically, you know, at that point I didn't know Saeed until I had the luck and perhaps the luck to go to Evin prison and get to know Saeed as a human being, and I realized what an amazing human being he is, so tolerant, and how he actually helped the African prisoners there without even caring about what their accusations was or anything. So he was a true humanitarian. He cared for humans because they were humans and nothing else.
من به عنوان آخر صحبتم اینو میخوام بگم بهتون، به خودمون، به من، به شما، به همه، که دفاع کردن از کسی مثل سعید پیش از اونی که کاری باشه برای سعید، کاری برای خودمون، خودمون رو نشانس بکنیم.
Say that, you know, when we're defending Sade, we're not doing this really for Sade, it's really for us, we're saving ourselves.
برای نجات خودمون، برای اینکه در این دنیایی که جنگ، ایرانی، نجات پرستی، زن ستیزی روز به روز داره توش رواج پیدا میکنه، بلندگاه رسمی پیدا میکنه، این ما باشیم که بگیم ما انسان، ما برای چیزی فراتر، برای انسانیت مبارزه کردیم تا این شعله رو نذاریم خاموش بشه و بذاریم که روزی در جهانی برابر و آزاد هممون زندگی کنیم. خیلی متشکرم.
Save ourselves in this world that's filled with wars and sexism and racism and all the troubles, the destructions that we see around us. It's for us to fight for a better world where there's equality and justice.
Thank you all very much. In all my years of doing stuff around Iran, this is the first Iran-focused event that's ended on time. So. I want to thank the panelists, I want to thank everybody that spoke. More than anything, I want to thank the organizers for bringing this group together. In just a moment, I'm going to ask everyone involved to please come up for a photo. All of you, all of us, we have the challenge before us to go out there and be Sade's advocate, to be Sade's voice. I really hope that we can live up to that challenge. Thank you all very much. Have a great night.
Yeah, we run the festival.